In this video, we're going to have a look at trig identities and how to prove certain things going on to use them. Now, we're going to have a look at how to actually derive these trig identities, first of all. Not that I would imagine you'd be asked to do that, but it's always good to understand where they come from. And all you really need to do that is to have a basic grasp of right-angle trigonometry, and some Pythagoras as well. So we know that sine of an angle is opposite over hypotenuse, cos of an angle is adjacent over hypotenuse, and tan of an angle is opposite over adjacent. Now if we take sine x over cos x, what we find is that that is opposite over hypotenuse divided by the adjacent over the hypotenuse. And what we've got there then is the opposite over the hypotenuse multiplied by the hypotenuse over the adjacent. Now the h's just cancel out. You end up with the opposite over the adjacent, which is tan x. So what we find is that sine x over cos x is equal to tan x. Okay, so that's your first trig identity, that tan x is sine x over cos x. Okay, and you need to know that, and you need to bear that in mind. The second thing we can think about is going back to a right angle triangle, and remembering that Pythagoras tells us that the hypotenuse squared is the sum of the square of the other two sides. If we then go on to think about what happens when we take sine squared x, or sine x all squared, and add to that cos squared x, what we end up with is opposite over hypotenuse all squared plus the adjacent over the hypotenuse all squared, which will give me opposite times the opposite gives me the opposite squared. Hypotenuse times hypotenuse gives me the hypotenuse squared. And similarly over here, we end up with a squared over h squared. We can collect it all over one denominator, since we have a common denominator of h squared. And we end up with o squared plus a squared. And as we mentioned earlier on, o squared plus h, a squared is just h squared. So what we end up with is h squared over h squared, and anything divided by itself is always 1. So what we find is that sine squared x plus cos squared x is equal to 1. Okay, so that's your first, that's your second trig identity. And you can rearrange that by making sine squared x your subject, and that gives you that sine squared x is 1 minus cos squared x. And similarly, if you were to rearrange it so that cos squared x was your subject, you would get the second result here, that cos squared x is 1 minus sine squared x. So you can think of this as kind of the parent formula, and from that you can derive this and this results for sine squared x and cos squared x. So you've got to remember all of that. You've got to remember that tan of an angle is sine of that angle over cos of the angle, and that sine squared of an angle plus cos squared of an angle is equal to 1. So with both these results, bearing them in mind, you can go on to then solve problems involving these trig identities. Okay, and they will usually always take the form of prove that or show that something is equal to something else. So what we'll do is we'll just run through a few examples of types of questions you could get, and then we will give you a few questions to do yourselves. Now, you know what you want to arrive at, okay? So you always want to arrive at the right-hand side, which in this case is sine x. Now, you always have to start with the left-hand side. So if you've got, in this case, tan x cos x, then, well, what do you know? You know tan x is sine x over cos x, and you're having to multiply that by cos x. Now, Anything divided by itself is going to cancel out. So that's you. Job done. Okay. All we did was we replaced tan of x with sine x over cos x, and we saw that the cos x is then cancelled out, and you end up with what you want to end up with. And that's that done. For this one, if we bear in mind that 1 minus cos squared x is sine squared x, okay, remember we said that sine squared x plus cos squared x was equal to 1, so 1 minus cos squared x has to be equal to sine squared x. So if you bear all of that in mind, you can rewrite the left-hand side as, and you can just say, well, 1 minus cos squared x over cos squared x, that's equal to sine squared x over cos squared x. Now, that's equal to sine x over cos x, all squared. And as you know, sine x over cos x, that's equal to tan x. So that's equal to tan x all squared. And we can arrive at our right-hand side, because tan x all squared is just the same as tan squared x. Okay. Now, there's no one approach that's going to work for every question, but what I'll try and do is just arm you with the skills that you can then take, or the tools that you can take to get on with whatever job you're faced with. Okay. This time we're asked to prove that cos x plus sine x all squared is equal to this. Okay. So let's start by multiplying out the brackets. So we'll just say that cos of x plus sine of x all squared is going to be cos of x plus sine of x multiplied by itself. And multiplying out the brackets, firsts, outsides, insides, lasts, I get cos x times itself plus two lots of sine x cos x. And then finally the lasts, I get sine x times itself, which is sine squared x. Now if you remember that sine squared x plus cos squared x makes 1, then I can just say, well, that leaves me with 1 plus 2 sine x cos x. And that's what I was asked to show. And that's me. Done. Okay. So, see how you get on with these three questions yourselves. Pause the video and come back and check and see if you manage to get the correct answers. So, let's have a look at the first one. What we've got is 4 sine squared a plus 4 cos squared a. If we were to get a common factor of 4, we find that we have sine squared a plus cos squared a in our bracket. Now we know that sine squared of an angle plus cos squared of an angle is always equal to 1. So 4 times 1 is just 4, and that's you done. Okay? Easy as that. The second example we'll do is cos squared y minus sine squared y. Bear in mind what you want to end up with. You're going from something with cos and sine mentioned in it, and you're ending up with something with just cos mentioned in it. So you want to get rid of the sine squared y. Now, if we bear in mind that sine squared of an angle is going to be 1 minus cos squared of that angle, okay, if we bear that result in mind, and if I then replace this sine squared y with 1 minus cos squared y, let's see what we get. So cos squared y minus sine squared y, that's going to be equal to cos squared y minus 1 minus cos squared y. So we end up with cos squared y minus 1 plus cos squared y, and that leaves me with what I wanted, 2 cos squared y minus 1. And that's us arrived at how we wanted it to be. Okay. Now the last one we're asked to do is to simplify this. So the questions we've done so far have asked us all to show something or to prove something. This one just asks us to simplify. So let's see what we can do. Well, we know that 1 minus sine squared of x is equal to cos squared of x. So we can say that, well, that's equal to 2 sine squared x over cos squared x. Now we know that's just the same as, if I consider this, it's 2 lots of sine x over cos x all squared. Now sine x over cos x, you know, is tan x, so you have 2 lots of tan x all squared, and you can simplify that and say that it's 2 tan squared x. So that says, having simplified that expression as far as we can, and that's really how you would deal with trig identities. So you've seen how to prove them. Not that I'd imagine you'd have to ever do that, but it always helps to see where they come from, and you might even be able to derive them yourselves if you end up forgetting them or not being sure exactly of what they are. And that's how you would use them. Start with the left-hand side, look at the right-hand side to see what you want to arrive at, and use each of the trig identities to maybe substitute in as you see fit to try and get what you want to arrive at. Okay, so I hope that was helpful.